Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Well, we almost have this chart working perfectly. We can choose under, average, or over, and Excel will change the color of the chart. Now, we set that up in the last 2 days' podcast. The one last thing that really drives me crazy about this chart is the legend is showing both the red, the yellow, and the green, when in fact we only have one of them on the chart. So I'm actually going to get rid of the legend. I'm going to click on it and press the delete key. I want to make our chart a little bit smaller, reduce the size of the plot area to give me some space at the top, and I'm going to add a text box. Draw a nice little text box in here, and that's going to hold the words under, average, or over. We'll format that text box to be a little bit larger. And now somewhere on my worksheet, I need to come up with a formula that will give me the words under, average, or over. And so right here next to where the option button is writing the values 1, 2, and 3, I'll use equal choose, and then in quotes, if it's a 1, we want an under, if it's 2, we want average, and if it's 3, we want over. Put all of those in quotes. And you see now as we choose average, we get the word average there, and when we choose over, we get the word over there. So that's all working well. I'm going to come here to my text box, click on the text box that way I have dots around the outside. And this cell, the cell that has the formula in it, is B7. And the worksheet that I happen to be on is called the chart worksheet. So with the text box selected, I'm going to click into the formula bar and type equal chart. That's the name of the worksheet, the exclamation point, and the cell that I want, B7. When I press enter, instantly, you'll see that that value appears in the text box. Now, let me format the text box so it's a little bit larger, maybe 18. And what we'll see is as I click on the chart in the option buttons, that changes the value in B7, and that allows the text box, because there's a formula assigned to the text box, to pick up the value from the worksheet instead of having it hard coded. So here we've basically now recreated that original chart that Lucy sent in. It took several days. And definitely some cool tricks along the way. At this point, if you want to rearrange the option buttons, we can do that. I find if you right click, we can then be able to move the option buttons. So I'll right click each one, maybe arrange them side by side by side. Move here, right click, move here, and now I can move my chart up. I always like to kind of resize this. The chart is a great way to hide those secret formulas that we set up on the first day, back on Monday. Well, there you have it. Great way to create an interactive chart that changes color as we choose the different option buttons. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.